I'm Mark Shirley, crawfish specialist with the LSU AgCenter and Louisiana Sea Grant. Today we're at the south farm of the rice research station looking at our crawfish ponds. And typically rice farmers will harvest their rice sometime in August or even July. And it's the ratoon growth, that regrowth from the rice plant itself, which will give the food supply for crawfish in the following winter and spring. How you manipulate that ratoon crop or that second growth will, we think, influence how much food supply is provided for the crawfish.
Hello, I'm Ronnie Levy with the LSU AgCenter. I'm the rice specialist, and I want to talk to you a little bit about second crop manipulation. We talk about rice crop in Louisiana. A lot of times we second crop rice, so we'll come in and harvest the crop, and then we manipulate the straw to come back to where we get a uniform second crop. To do that, we'll come in and either roll it, or we'll come in with some type of cutter where we'll either rotary cut it or bush hog it down to a lower level so that we get the plant to come back from the crown instead of from the stem. If you look at this plant, you'll see that the tillers came back from this node on the stem, which causes the plant to actually be smaller head and not as uniform. What we'd like is the tillers to come back from the crown of the plant, all the way from the base, where they actually have a more vegetative growth. We get a lot more uniformity in the amount of straw that's produced. And this is what we feel like is a better manipulation of straw for second crop production or crawfish production.
In our demonstration here, we have four different methods. One method, we just scattered the straw after the combine cut the rice. The second method, we rolled the stubble such that it broke it right at the soil line. We also have a treatment where we bush hogged it. And then the fourth one, we actually burned the straw off the top of the stubble and let the sunlight in and let the plant regrow. So these are four different methods that farmers might use. And we're going to measure the difference all throughout the crawfish season this winter and on into the spring. So we'll actually determine what's the best way to manipulate a rice crop after harvest to provide the best food supply for crawfish throughout the crawfish season. So we'll give you a report on that at the end of the crawfish season once we know just how we do.